When the show wrapped up its time on TV, there were still a lot of questions the writers and showrunners never answered. Better Call Saul and El Camino did answer some, but in this video, we're going to discuss what questions Breaking Bad just never answered. Before we get started, you know what you gotta do. That like button, hit it. The subscribe button, freaking destroy it. That notification bell, ding it, bitch. Your boy is trying to hit 1,000 subscribers before the end of the month, so please make that goal possible. With that out of the way, let's get into it. These questions are in no particular order, but for the first one, let's talk about everyone's favorite character, Skyler. In Season 4, Episode 6, she goes to the Four Corners, flips a coin that lands in Colorado twice, shifts the coin to New Mexico, and goes home. Some viewers are still left wondering as to what the scene meant. In a cast and crew commentary of the episode, the writers discuss this scene. For one, that isn't Skyler in the wide shot. It was actually a body double because the drive was 6 hours and they couldn't spare the time during their filming days. Two, it was filmed on a small Canon 5D camera. And three, the close-ups were done outside their studio. As far as what the meaning meant behind it, it's more or less about Skyler wanting a sign that she is doing the right thing. She wanted the coin to land in her state, but as we see, the powers that be are telling her to go to Colorado. However, she refutes this and goes back home. Now, what is up with that stupid red teddy bear? Vince wanted that teddy bear specifically made for the show, so there has to be a specific reason why the doll is in those black and white scenes during Season 2, as well as parts of Season 3. A lot of people think that foreshadows Gus Fring's death in Season 4, but that is not true. The showrunners want to admit originally that Gus Fring was not a major character. It was the actor Giancarlo Esposito that campaigned to have this guy be a bigger deal than what he was. Probably when the writers were mapping out how to murder Fring, they made a callback to the bear. If it wasn't a foreshadow, what was it? Overall, the showrunners have strayed away from answers, but if you look deeper into it, you'll find your answer. Basically, the bear represents that Walt's actions have consequences. Every choice he makes affects not just him, but everyone around him. The black and white mixed with the solo pink coloring is also an homage to Schindler's List, a movie which used the same filming technique to represent a very similar theme. Another huge question left out in the open is, did Gretchen and Elliot fulfill Walt's promise? Either the rich couple did as Walt asked, or they didn't. El Camino didn't seem to do too much answering of that question when showing Jesse's journey escaping Albuquerque. You could theorize that if Gretchen did not give Junior the money, it would have ended up on the news or something, in which Jesse and his pals would have overheard. The showrunners haven't been straight when answering this question, so for the glass half full people, the family got the money, and for the glass half empty people, Gretchen never gave it away. While talking about Gretchen, what exactly happened between her and Walt? And with that, what happened between him and Gray Matter? Well, a lot of people have this question in their head after the show alluded to something between the two in the flashbacks. From the clips of the two on screen, one can infer they had an affair while Gretchen was dating Elliot. Or you can even say Walt and Gretchen were dating before she met with Elliot. One can say that Walt wanted Gretchen to choose between him and Elliot if she was dating Elliot at the time, but as you know, the rest is history. What is also interesting is that the episode on Netflix cuts the scene early. In this classroom setting, they go on to say, "There's nothing but chemistry here." And they almost look like they're about to kiss. So that's also very interesting to know. With the topic of infidelity, let's talk about our favorite two characters, Skyler and Ted. When we last saw Ted, he was last seen in a hospital after a head injury. So what happened to him? Will he ever recover? I mean, we saw that his head injury was so severe that it caused him to become bald. If you try to Google search what happened to someone in that predicament, they must go through extensive surgeries, take tons of medication, and even go through a rehabilitation program that could take months or even years to complete. I don't think Ted died. He will recover, but not for a long time. Now, the most popular episode in Breaking Bad, the Fly episode, has left a lot of questions, mainly what it meant. According to the showrunners, the episode was never in the outline of the season. Due to them being way over budget, AMC required an episode that cost almost nothing, calling it a bottle episode. You probably already know that. The writers came up with the idea to keep Walt and Jesse at the lab for 80% of the episode. As far as the meaning behind it, you know Rian Johnson, the director of the episode, has a few ideas up his sleeve. Also, he's the director of The Last Jedi, need I say less. Basically, The fly represents Walt's guilt and his inability to get rid of it. Some suggest it mainly represents Jane, while others summarize the guilt to all the consequences brought about by Walt. He can't sleep in the beginning and at the end because of the quote-unquote fly slash his guilty conscience. In Season 2, Episode 7, Skylar goes back to work, and she mentioned how she originally worked with Beneke before, but ultimately left the position. She originally left because of the quote-unquote welding fumes, but as the series went on, a scandal unfolded that left fans wondering if the fumes were the real reason she quit in the first place. The show never elaborated on the topic besides a one-off line, possibly referring to an instance when Skylar was sexually harassed by Ted. Besides that, we don't really know what happened between the two back then, and I don't think we will. The next loose end Breaking Bad left is a pretty big one. What happened to Gus Fring back in Chile? The more Better Call Saul continues, the more information we get on Gus Fring's background, but both shows never fully head-on address Gus's history in Chile. All we know is that Gus used to live in Chile before moving to Mexico in 1986 during a dictator's reign. Apparently, all of Fring's records before 1986 are non-existent, and the cartel knows about Fring's Chile past. Season 4, Episode 8 shows Don Eladio spare Fring's life because he knows who he really is and how he isn't in Chile anymore. Some theorize that Fring was actually part of the dictator's regime in Chile, but we won't fully know. If this theory is true, it explains why Fring is so ruthless with his enemies. Hopefully, as Better Call Saul continues and eventually wraps up, we understand more about Fring's background. The second to last question of the day relates to post-Breaking Bad. As the viewers know, Marie resorted to shoplifting to relieve stress and to distract herself from her crappy life with Cranky Hank. With that, her husband is now dead. Does that mean she is no longer a woman of class and is now back to robbing stores? If so, it is possible she is sitting in a jail cell right now. Sadly, I don't think we'll ever find out if Marie ever recovered from her husband's death. The last question Breaking Bad never answered was, what happened to Huel? When we last saw him, he was told to stay at a motel room in order to stay safe from Walter White. When Hank and Steve died, how would Huel know when to leave? I'm sure he's out now, but it is possible that he was stuck in that room for days or even weeks, but we just won't know for sure. So, those are just some of the questions Breaking Bad never answered. One can only hope Better Call Saul might answer some of these, but it's not good to wish for something that most likely won't come. Anyway, thanks for watching. Be sure to look in the video, comment, leave a comment if you leave a mother-freaking comment. Subscribe if you're new between me, you, and Heisenberg, and Vinci, and PETA. Have a wonderful day, and peace out.